Let us continue with our lesson over here. And today we learn about the delete. So how to delete our record. So first of all, let me create a new method. And I will just say as delete data over here. And that's good. And let's select our table. So we need to take a table variable of this one. Or else we'll just copy from our here. That should be better. Let's copy this one and go to over here and just paste it. That's it, and let's save it. And we have a table variable over now, and what we need to do is we need to delete it. So how do we delete it? We need to first set as a TTS begin over here, TTS begin, and after that we will use a select. So I will just say select and select the table from here, which is a demo.dml table. Where, and I will use a where condition, where DML demo table dot sales ID, let's say sales ID is equals to, and let me browse the table, and I will just select this one. So let us delete this sales ID 000754. So I'll just go over here and just paste it, and yeah, that's it. It will go and delete the table. And for delete we need to use a method of we need to make use of our let's copy our demo DML table. Let's go down that and we'll just use a delete option over here. So we have a built-in method for delete, just use that one, and that's it. And we use a TTS commit after that, and let's run this one. Let's run it. Okay, if you go and check this record, let's go and open. I think it will just delete a first record for us. So it just deleted our first record for us. And let's see how to delete a multiple record. So we have used this one to delete our first record. Or else let us try to delete our first record from here, which each of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which has a delivery term of FOC. FOB, and the delivery name you can see Contoso Retro San Diego, and I'll just copy this sales ID, and let me go back over here and just paste this one, and let me run it again. And that's okay. If you open the table, then that one should be removed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is still there. So let's see why it is not removing. Yeah, I know, because if we haven't put it inside our run method, that's the problem. Every time forget to update my run method. So this the deleted data, yeah, over here, and I think that should be fine. Yeah, every time I come I have to update over here, I always forget it. Sorry for that, guys. And let's run it, and yeah, it's saying that okay, so our SQL statement is not correct. So let's go to our delete, and what we have to do is select, and we are just selecting the record. And if you try to run it, you will see the error that cannot delete because the operation cannot complete since the record was not selected for update. So that's the error we are getting over here, right? So since the record was not selected for update. So how to fix that one is we will make use of select, and if you remember when we update it, we use a for update. Yeah, we have to use this one. So if we never select for update, and that we cannot delete a record because it will not sell it's not able to select the record for us to delete it or update it, because when we delete it still it's going to update it. So let's run it, and yeah, that should be fine. And if you go and open it, and we will see that our first record got deleted. So if we again run that one, that should delete the first record again. So if we just refresh this one, yeah, only one record is left. So that's how we make use of our delete over here, delete method to delete our record from here. So make sure you make use of a for update. Don't forget to put a for update for here, and if you never put it, then we are not able to delete it. So let's continue with the next lecture. Till then, have a great day.